I'm in Paris Airport. I have 1 hour before my next flight to Dubai, and I want to create an automation that's going to turn my videos into articles, X, and LinkedIn posts. It's 12:44 right now, and my flight is at 13:44. Let's see what I can do.
So in my last challenge, I created an automation that takes my video and turns it into a transcript. So I'm gonna be using that transcript and turn it into a post, an X post, tweets, and LinkedIn.
So I'm gonna start with from my transcript.
All right. So in my Cloud Station account, you can see here that I already have all the tools that I'm gonna be using: n8n, NocoDB, and Minio. And that's because in the last video I created a content generator workflow, which is what you see here, and I'm gonna be using it as a base to actually generate LinkedIn posts. So in the last time I actually was able to transcribe a video file and to generate description and chapter markers based on the transcription. So I'm just gonna clone the OpenAI node that's responsible for generating chapter markers, and I'm gonna rename it to generate LinkedIn or article posts. Alright, so I'm gonna go to Claude and I'm gonna use it to generate a prompt, a system prompt, and a user prompt to generate an article. A LinkedIn article using the transcription that I have already. So basically the system prompt is gonna be just telling the assistant that it's a specialized agent in generating LinkedIn posts, and then on the user prompt I'm just gonna pass it the necessary files. So it's gonna be a transcript, which is a text of the entire video. So based on that, I should be able to create a LinkedIn post that I should be able to then post on LinkedIn automatically. So I'm just gonna drag and drop the data extracted in the expression part. And I'm gonna test it to see the generated content. All right, so I can see here that I have on top of the content, I have the role and other fields on the JSON. So I'm gonna add the get field node. I'm just gonna clone it as well. And I'm gonna use it to get only the content of the generated LinkedIn post. So I'm gonna rename it to extract content, and I'm gonna test it. Now I have the LinkedIn post. So next I'm gonna add a LinkedIn node that's gonna post to LinkedIn automatically. I'm gonna add my account. So I have already added my account, but to add it, it's basically just following the instruction from n8n. And then all I need to do is in the text area, I'm just gonna drag and drop the chapters, because I didn't rename it yet, as article. I need to choose which account, and then I'm gonna test the step to see what it's generating. I'm just fixing the prompt because it seems that I have copied some everything in the same user. And I'm gonna test every step on its own to then generate and post the article on LinkedIn. And I'm gonna rename this to post because it's not a chapter. And then I'm gonna copy the JSON that was generated to use it as a mock data for my LinkedIn post. So we have an error here, and that's because I renamed the content to post instead of chapters. Let's test again, and we have an error. I'm just gonna change the type. I'm gonna change the type from article to none and test, see if that's the issue. And yes, it works. So right now I am able to post directly to LinkedIn, and I'm gonna go and check.
So I have successfully created a post for my YouTube video, but I need to validate my content before they upload it to LinkedIn. So I'm gonna add a second automation to first post the LinkedIn post to my NocoDB, and then if I validate it, it's gonna go and get posted in on LinkedIn.
Let's first delete the LinkedIn post, and now I'm gonna go to NocoDB. To my NocoDB instance to create a new table for the LinkedIn posts. So in the last video I have showed how I created this NocoDB instance, but now I'm just gonna create a new table. I'm gonna call it LinkedIn, and I'm gonna add to it a long text for the articles. And the status, so that whenever I create a new article, it's first in review, and then if I approve it, it's gonna get posted automatically, and if I archive it, it's gonna stay in the archive. I'm gonna set the default value to review, that's by choosing some colors, and the default value is review. So I already added my credentials from the last video, and this time I'm gonna choose the LinkedIn table to populate from the OpenAI content. So the field name is gonna be the title, and it's gonna be the video name. So I have it from the webhook. From the previous steps, and then for the article it's gonna be the newly generated content, so what I extract from the OpenAI response. Then I will test and go check in NocoDB to see if it has arrived, and yes, and the status is in review. I have the generated content ready to be reviewed, and if I have some fixes I want to do, or like for example it mistakenly spelled Minayo, if I want to edit any of the generated posts, which what we should do for generated AI content, we shouldn't just upload it as is. So that's my workflow, and I just wanna automate it and make it easier. I don't wanna use AI to do everything for me.
Okay, so now I have set up my NocoDB. I created a new table that will have my LinkedIn post. Title will be the title of the video, and the posts are whatever the AI is generated. So what's gonna happen now is I'm gonna fix any errors on my post, and once it's fixed and the article is on the post column, automatically post the article on LinkedIn. So right now I'm gonna set up this automation on n8n.
Okay, so I want the webhook to be triggered whenever a post status is gone from review to post. So on record updates, I need to pass a webhook URL. I'm gonna create a webhook in n8n that I will pass here. So let's separate the LinkedIn node from here, and instead let's grab a webhook node, and let's get the URL. It's gonna be a post webhook, and what's gonna happen is whenever the webhook is triggered, it should post the LinkedIn article. So it should be triggered when the status of the article is equal to post. So the default one is a review. So whenever we move it from review to post, it should trigger the webhook. I'm just gonna copy the I'm gonna listen to the webhook events. So I'm gonna test with the test URL, copy it and test the webhook. And I'm getting the information from here. So I'm gonna grab this little nodes and I'm gonna copy them in a new workflow that is gonna be specifically there to post validated articles into LinkedIn. So I'm gonna retest with this new webhook URL. I'm just gonna copy it in the same webhook in NocoDB. And test it. I should have received the events in n8n. So I'm gonna now update the webhook URL to the post, to the production one. And next, we need to update the LinkedIn to post the article that's coming from the webhook. And let's test this step. And it should have posted that LinkedIn post. So let's delete it. And save and activate. And let's call it post on LinkedIn. So now if I update the status to post, it should activate a new execution and we have an error. So we're not getting the right field.
I don't have enough time. I'm gonna finish on the plate. Right, my automation is almost done. I just need to post the article into LinkedIn, which I already done. It's just not working for now. I'm just gonna debug it and hopefully finish it before we take off.
Right, so I'm gonna get the last execution so that I can debug with it, and I'm gonna copy the selection. And in the editor, I'm gonna put it as a mock data. Alright, and in the editor, I'm gonna go and update the mock data to use the actual one. Save. And in the LinkedIn node, I'm gonna use the row 0. That article, which should fix the issue. And now if I test, I should have a URL. And if I go back to LinkedIn, we have the article. For the post, I'm gonna delete for now and save the workflow, and I'm gonna clean up the content generator workflow and remove the unnecessary webhook and LinkedIn nodes that I added there.
It's done. In time. So I just did two simple workflows, one to create the LinkedIn post and one that listens to the NocoDB events to see if I manually approve the post, it's gonna post it to LinkedIn.